Welcome to my YouTube channel. This is first time I talk on this channel. Otherwise, I always play the piano or the organ here. I'm looking like this because I had a ski accident this year, but the doctor says I'm gonna be all right. I live on the country, very close to the ocean, in the middle of Sweden. You can hear that in my music when I play, because I like water very much. This summer was fantastic because I could buy myself a new grand piano. I was looking for Fazioli F212 or a Steinway Model B. It's 211 centimeters. That size of instrument is very nice for me. It's very clean sound in that. If you buy a bigger instrument like a Steinway Model D, you need a very big room for that because it's so big sound in it. So earlier this summer, I was looking on eBay for nice piano dealers in Europe. I find 3 of them and maybe 15 instruments to look at. So I took my car first. It's maybe 600 kilometers to Copenhagen in Denmark. And there is the piano company Mattsson and Mackie. And Gorm and Klaus, the owner of that, told me they had 3 instruments at home. 2 Fazioli F212 and 1 F278. After Copenhagen, I drove to Heimersheim. It's a small village outside Bonn in Germany. So it is another 900 kilometers to drive. And I went to the piano company Piano Spengler. And the owner, Rudolf, he doesn't speak so much English, he told me, but I talked with his son, Mattis, and they showed me around. They had 5 Steinways Model B, renovated and very nice instrument. But only 3 of them fits me because I need 88 keys and 2 of them only had 85 keys. And after that, I went to Werkhofen outside Utrecht in Holland to Evert Schnell piano. He had 2 Steinways Model B, but only 1 for sale. And the other one was a Fazioli F228. I met Evert. He was a very nice man and very happy, I think. And his son Egbert took care of me in Holland. So now I'm going to show you how it sounds like. On the first video, I tried 10 grand pianos and I played Debussy, the arabesque number 1, and I play maybe 10 or 15 seconds on each instrument. Don't forget to have your earphones on or a nice speakers. Thank you. The second piece I show you is a prelude in A major, written by me. And now I show you 8 grand pianos. It's not easy to decide this. It's very much money in this, and I only have afford with one piano. So I definitely have to do the right choice now. Some grand pianos can sound very good in some piano music, but very bad in other piano music. So I know what to record on my piano, so I must find some grand piano that fits my music. So I had to take long walks, listen in my earphones, sleep well, drink coffee, beer, and smoke my pipe just to clean my thoughts, to make my head very clean. And then, after a couple days later, I decide. When I looked at eBay this spring, the first grand piano I saw was the Steinway Makassar edition, the brown grand piano in Rudolf Spengler's showroom. When I saw that piano first time, it was like a white shimmer over that in the picture. And I think that piano is mine. But when I listen in my long walks, I just had numbers on the piano. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and so on. I didn't know what piano it was. I listen, what is the best sound for me? And it was the grand piano number 6. That was my sound. And then I look, what is number 6? It's a brown Steinway & Sons Model B. Wow, it's so beautiful piano, and it's the best sound for me. But that piano was reserved for someone else. So I emailed Mattis Rudolfsson and said, can I come tomorrow and buy it of you? And he said, yes, if you come tomorrow, you can buy it. So I went back to Bonn again and bought it. But it was several things that must be fixed on the piano. Some mechanics and some intonation must change a little bit in it. So Rudolf Spengler gave me a 1 hour lesson how to fix the piano. And I am very interested in that because here in Sweden I work as a piano tuner. After 3 weeks, a Polish piano company came with the grand piano to my house. And here you can see how it looked like. I have to fix my garden and remove everything to my office so I can get the grand piano inside my studio. And now it is at home, and I hope I can do a lot of recordings when my shoulder is better. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel so you don't miss any new recordings from this nice piano. Thank you for watching.